everybody. Welcome back to The Peaks, the web series where we talk about live music video and share the best video moments from around the net with you. Now, this week, music fans are, of course, mourning the loss of Clarence Clemons, the tenor saxophonist in Bruce Springsteen's E Street Band, who sadly passed away on Saturday night from complications of a stroke. He was 69 years old. Here's the RockPeaks tribute to the big man with a saxophone. That, of course, is the infectious high-octane sax riff from Born to Run, Springsteen's breakthrough 1975 album. I have a copy of it right here. Actually features a picture of Clarence on the back cover. There you go, there are the two of them. One of the most iconic shots in rock and roll, taken by Eric Miola. And that clip is available on the deluxe 30th anniversary edition of the album. It's a package well worth checking out. It's got some of the earliest known footage of the E Street Band, and including this next track, Spirit in the Night, which is the second single from the Boss's first album, Greetings from Asbury Park. Here it is, check it out. So the story of how Clemons came to join the E Street Band is an oft-told tale, endlessly recounted on stage, and he'd even made it into the storyline of 10th Avenue Freeze-Out. But here it is from the man himself, as told to Canadian talk show host Alan Thicke in the early 80s.
It's basically true, you know. I was playing in another bar around the corner from the bar he was playing in, and I went around to jam with him. And when I went in, I opened a door, and this wind just blew the door right down the street, you know. And I walk in, I says, I want to sit in. He says, sure, anything, you know. Sure. You want a background singer, anything you want, you know, this guy. And I got on stage and I played with him. It was like magic. It started, and it's been the same way ever since.
The big man's always been a great foil for the Boss on stage. Here we are in the middle of the magnificent Rosalita. The two were trading riffs back and forth in a kind of call and response way. Just love the way that Clemons' sax line has taken over seamlessly from where Springsteen's lyrics left off, continuing to evoke the emotional pull of the song as things build towards the chorus. Clemons' solo career wasn't all that prolific, with only two releases to his name, but the first album he released, Rescue, was recorded with the Red Bank Rockers, and it's worth a listen. Definitely shows there was at least two good bar bands at work in New Jersey. Here they are on Swedish television in early 1984, just before the release of Born in the USA. Jump start now! Jump start now! We saved the best for last. This is probably Clarence Clemons' most famous and distinctive sax turn. It's the middle few minutes from Jungleland off of Born to Run, and it's a solo that he spent 14 hours perfecting in the studio during the recording of that album. This performance comes to us from the 2009 Rock and Roll Hall of Fame 25th Anniversary Concert. And incidentally, Springsteen himself was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 99, but the E Street Band have yet to receive that honor. No word as to whether the band will be continuing without their legendary sax man.